Hello, everyone, and welcome to this year's Christmas Mystery. St. Mary's Hall and Doane Academy have been staging this production since 1847, and I think it's fair to say that we've never had a year in all of those years quite like 2020. We're really excited to be able to show you the Christmas Mystery, albeit in a somewhat different format this year. And before we get started, I really do want to thank all of those who were responsible for putting this production together. In particular, Megan Tynan, our theater director, Shelley Zuckerman, our music director, and Jack Newman, our director of communications. All of them put in countless hours to bring this production to you this evening. So thank you for being here. The history of the Christmas Mystery is really remarkable. And to tell you a little bit more about that, I'd like to pass things over to the senior class president, Layla Abdullah.
Welcome, students, parents, alumni, and friends of Doane Academy to the Christmas Mystery. Every year around this time when the school begins preparing its chapter in the history of this performance, the same questions inevitably echo throughout the halls. Why do they perform the mystery, and why not have a different Christmas play each year? The answer to these questions can be found by tracing the antique history of the Christmas Mystery at St. Mary's Hall. Founded in 1837 as an all-girls boarding school by Bishop George Washington Doane, St. Mary's Hall was a leader in the monument for women's education. Many of the young ladies who attended St. Mary's Hall boarded here, and many traveled great distances to be here because of the great distance between school and home and the difficulty of traveling at the time. Many of the young ladies stayed at the hall throughout the Christmas holiday. Having no family members to share the wonders of Christmas with, these young ladies decided to celebrate Christmas together by performing a pageant about the birth of Jesus. Years ago, in 1848, the members of St. Mary's Hall attended the first Christmas Eve service in this chapel. Decorated with wreath and holly and laurel by the senior class, the chapel must have prepared much as it does this evening. A chorus of Christmas carol and hymns followed the service. The students then put on the first version of the mystery in the form of a tableau, or a silent scene depicting the Nativity. The events of the Christmas Live in 1848 became an annual tradition. By 1930, years ago, the Christmas Mystery became the performance that it is today. Today, the mystery is performed by the students of Doane Academy with the same sense of family as our predecessors. The Christmas Mystery has remained the strongest tradition carried on by the students of Doane Academy. Through the years, the school has gone through many changes, but the one constant that has remained and will always remain is the Christmas Mystery. All of us who are watching tonight have gathered because of the warmth and family feeling that still fills the air. Christmas Mystery is a unique part of the history of Doane Academy, and it is with sincere wishes for a happy holiday season that I welcome you tonight. Thank you.
Come for ye, my people, saith your God. Speak ye comfortably to Jerusalem and cry unto her, that her warfare is accomplished, that her iniquity is pardoned. For she hath received of the Lord's hand double for all her sins. The voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare yet the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be exalted, and every mountain and hill shall be made low. And the crooked shall be made straight, and the rough places plain. And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed. And all the flesh shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord hath spoken it. And the voice said, Cry. And he said, What shall I cry? All flesh is grass, and all the goodliness thereof is as the flower of the field. The grass withereth, the flower fadeth, because the Spirit of the Lord bloweth upon it. Surely the people in the grass. The grass withereth, the flower fadeth, but the word of our God shall stand forever. O Zion, that bringest good tidings, get thee up into the high mountain. O Jerusalem, that bringest good tidings, lift up thy voice with strength lifted up. Be not afraid. Say unto the cities of Judah, Behold your God. Behold the Lord. God will come with strong hand, and his arm shall rule for him. Behold, his reward is with him, and his work before him. He shall feed his flock like a shepherd. He shall gather the lambs with his arm, and carry them in his bosom, and shall gently lead those that are with young. Here ends the reading. Please rise and sing verses 2 and 3 of hymn number, Veni Emmanuel.
Oh, come thou wisdom from above.
from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 9, verses 2 through 7. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shined. Thou hast multiplied the nation and not increased the joy. They joy before thee according to the joy in harvest, and as men rejoice when they divide the spoil. For thou hast broken the yoke of his burden, and the staff of his shoulder, the rod of his oppressor, as in the day of Midian. For every battle of the warrior is with confused noise, and garments rolled in blood, but this shall be with burning and fuel of fire. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end, upon the throne of David, and upon his kingdom to order it, to establish it with judgment, and with justice, from henceforth, even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Here ends the reading. Please rise and sing verses 4 and 5 of hymn Veni Emmanuel. A reading from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 11, verses 1 through 10. And there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse, and branch shall grow out of his roots. And the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. And shall make him of quick understanding in the fear of the Lord. And he shall not judge after the sight of his eyes, neither reprove after the hearing of his ears. But with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and reprove with equity for the meek of the earth. And he shall smite the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips shall he slay the wicked. And righteousness shall be the girdle of his loins, and faithfulness the girdle of his reins. The wolf also shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and the calf, and the young lion, and the fatling together. And the little child shall lead them. And the cow and the bear shall feed, their young ones shall lie down together. And the lion shall eat straw like the ox. And the sucking child shall play on the hole of the asp. And the weaned child shall put his hand on the adder's den. They shall not hurt nor destroy in all my holy mountain. For the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as would the waters cover the sea. And in that day there shall be a root of Jesse, which shall stand for an ensign of the people. To it shall the Gentiles seek, and his rest shall be glorious. Here ends the reading. Please rise and sing verses 6 and 7 of hymn Veni Emmanuel.
And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city in Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man named Joseph, of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary.
O God, whose mercy is on them that fear thee throughout all generations, show forth the strength of thy right arm, scatter the proud in the imagination of their hearts. Help thy servant Israel as thou hast promised.
Hail, thou art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you amongst women.
What manner of salutation is this?
Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with the Lord. And behold, unto you a son shall be born, and you shall call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and he shall be called the Son in the highest. And the Lord God shall put upon him the throne of his fathers, David. And he shall rule over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom shall have no end.
How shall this be?
The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the powers of the highest overshadow thee. And so this holy thing born unto you shall be called the Son of God, for with God nothing is impossible.
Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word.
And the angel departed from her. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone unto his own city, and Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth into Judea, unto the city of David, which is also called Bethlehem, because he was of the house of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife.
And so it was that while they were there, she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night.
I heard a curious thing in Jerusalem yesterday when I took the yearlings to the temple.
What was it, Bartholomew?
I have an aged kinsman, Simeon by name, who is very devout. You may have seen him in the temple courts. He is often there.
Yes, I know him well.
And I.
He still waits for the consolations of Israel. When I am despondent because the times are evil, he says, Messiah will surely come.
Dost not recall, Bartholomew, the words of the prophet Isaiah? The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shone.
I love to think of it, and then the rest of it. For unto us a child is born, unto us a child is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
That is our one and only hope. We must cling to it.
Well, this Simeon told me that God has revealed to him that he should not see death before he has seen the Lord's Christ.
If that be true, Christ will soon come, for Simeon cannot live much longer.
May he come quickly, for our need is sore.
Fear not, for behold, I bring thee tidings of great joy, which shall be unto all people. For unto you this day is born in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. This shall be a sign unto you. You shall find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
They are gone.
They have gone from us into heaven from whence they came.
Let us go, even unto Bethlehem.
Aye, let us see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us.
Yet in my dark streets shall
Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east of Jerusalem, saying, Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and have come to worship him.
Then Herod inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, Go search diligently for the young child, and when ye have found him, bring me word again, then I may come and worship him also. When they heard the king, they departed. And lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy.
Thank you. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have given your only begotten Son to take our nature upon him and to be born of a pure virgin. Grant that we who have been born again and made your children by adoption and grace may daily be renewed by your Holy Spirit through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Father in heaven, you have poured upon us the new light of your incarnate word. Grant that this light enkindled in our hearts may shine forth in our lives through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. O God, by the leading of a star, you manifested your only Son to the peoples of the earth. Lead us who know you now by faith to your presence, where we may see your glory face to face. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. As Christ, the Son of God, came into the world in his holy incarnation, so may he come into your hearts and minds in this holy season and fill your lives with his joy and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen.